I got a problem. I got a strange addiction. Somebody help me. I need an intervention. It ain't alcohol or weed. There's just one thing that I need. I got an addiction to fruit trees. I got an addiction to fruit trees. I take a persimmon to please. Hey, the next one I'm getting, jujube.
Peace, family. Just wanted to hop on real quick and give you all a quick, just a real quick update on what's been going on here. First off, let's start with the potatoes. We got the two buckets of my red potatoes. Both of them are red potatoes because that's what we eat around here. Now they're coming up pretty good. I'm actually going to put some more soil and wood chips in here. They actually were coming up pretty good, you know, initially, but then we got like this unexpected cold snap, this frost that took out the foliage. And so, you know, I just figured, well, you know, I'll just let them sit there and pop back up. And they came back pretty strong. So that makes me feel good as far as, you know, if they came back from that, they should be a good harvest this year. But those are my red potatoes. So this is my, this tree is the Mutsu, or the Crispin. Now, there's nothing really going on too much with it right now. I've scratched it. It's still green, so I guess it's just not its time. Now, I'm going to explain this in just a second as well. But we got the strawberries growing here. And they're looking pretty good. Looking pretty good. My little baby jujube, she's looking pretty good. Now, it looks like she has, I don't know if that, I think that's flower buds, I'm assuming. But she's got buds coming up. And then the strawberries that I planted in here, they're doing pretty good. Now, if you look at the strawberries, the white stuff that you see on the strawberries and on a few other things, that is when I made bone meal a few days ago. And I took the water from the bone meal. And, you know, when I put it through the blender, put the water through the blender to try to get the bone meal residue off, it just left that... there was some white stuff that came with it. It's pretty much bone meal, so you know that'll come off after after I water it or when it rains. So more strawberries, and this one here is my Braeburn. She's leafing up pretty good, and I'll explain that in a minute as well. But the strawberries are doing pretty good. Now, I mentioned to you all, I asked you all about figs because I've never done figs before. So I actually went back and bought three of these little figs that they had on clearance at Malwart. Now, I'm glad that I saw Angela's Busy Bee's Garden, her video. She mentioned figs and was saying that they sometimes can be like some of the last things that bloom or do anything. Now these, they are still alive. I scratched them, but I was kind of getting discouraged because they weren't doing anything. But then, you know, if you pull back some of this mulch that I put down, there's like little green buds that have been coming up. So, you know, that's, I'm just gonna wait. And then this one here is another fig. Let me come around. This is another fig that I bought. This is a different kind. This is actually a Chicago fig. The other three are Olympia figs, but this is a Chicago hardy fig. So I just figured I'd give that a try. You know, again, family, I've never had figs before. Only figs I've ever had was Fig Newtons. You know, after I bought the three containers of figs, I tried some dry figs. I wasn't really all that impressed, but then I thought nothing really tastes as good as when you grow it at home. So, you know. And this apple tree, this is my yellow delicious or golden delicious, and the leaves are coming up pretty good on that. Now, I do want to show you my peach tree. It's blooming, or, you know, not even blooming, because the blooms are gone now, and it just has fruit, like ripe fruit, ready for the picking, huge. I mean, it's loaded with fruit. The fruit is huge. I'm gonna go ahead and show that to you. Bam! Look at, hold on. Don't tell me y'all can't see the fruit, because it's huge. Look at that big, beautiful. Oh man, that thing, I can smell it. I can smell it. Let me show you, let me get to some more here. I mean, I know you can see them all because they're so big. I mean, there's a lot of them. I'm having to like fight ants and stuff from, I mean, there's some back here. Can you see, hold on. Can you see? See how, oh my God. Oh man, they are so ripe. I can smell the ripe. I'm about to, family. I'm sorry, the peaches are so big, they was knocking the camera out. Here's another one. It's, I mean, huge, huge peaches. Where's the other one? Right here. Oh my gosh. I mean, just, they're everywhere. Everywhere. Here's another one. They're everywhere. I mean, just huge, perfect peaches. I mean, listen, I'm picking this tomorrow. I could pick this and eat these today. I mean, there's so many things that I'm going to do with this. I'm going to make, I'm going to look up somebody's video and make some jam. I'm going to eat them raw while I do yard work. I'm eating these tomorrow. Only reason why I'm not going to do it today is because, I'm trying to make videos and, do some other things. So I'm going to wait till tomorrow when I have a few more free minutes after work. I'll come back and pick these peaches. I mean, but come on. Just ripe. Just ripe for the picking. Oh, yeah. All right, so here's another strawberry plant. Here's some more strawberries that are here with my persimmon. She took a long time to come awake, but, you know, I'm assuming that's normal, but she's waking up now. Hey, baby. And in here, we got this peach tree. Now, family, I'm thinking that she's gone. I think she might be down for the count, honestly. I mean, if you all think otherwise, let me know. I scratched it, and you gotta scratch it pretty deep to get to green. So I think she might be out. But here's some more strawberries. Like I said, the stuff that's on it is just bone meal residue. And then here's another thing. I was gonna do a totally different video for this, but I didn't unbox it. Here's the newest addition to the family. Got me a pink lady apple. A pink lady apple tree. Pink lady apple. So you know, I got a name on my trees. One day I'm gonna do a video and I'm gonna just tell you the names of everything. But if y'all have name suggestions for this one, just put that in the comments. But that's my pink lady apple. I'm excited about her. And all right, so just to kind of, well, before we explain that, in this container is more strawberries, and they actually are already looking a little bit better. So these I started inside from bare root. These were the Albions, some of the Albions that came in, and they did pretty good inside. When I brought them outside, you know, I guess it was kind of, I should have waited till it got warmer, but they pulled through, and they're giving off runners as well. So I was thinking, because I had them sitting over here before and they did okay, but they just seemed like they needed a little bit more light. And I think I might have put, you know, the soil level down too much, because this part of the container, or really depending on where the sun is, sometimes it kind of blocks sunlight. So I was thinking that maybe I should transplant them somewhere else. I don't know. I mean, let me know if y'all know about strawberries, because I've never grown strawberries before. If you know about strawberries, is it safe for me to pull these up and put them somewhere else, or should I just wait till they go dormant? Well, I actually thought also about just pulling them up, raising the soil level, and then putting them back. So, but you guys let me know. All right, so let's talk about these things here. So I got this situation going on right here. and I've got this situation going on right here. So, as you all know, I did that video where I was trying my hand at grafting, and I grafted this mystery apple tree branch onto the rootstock of a tree that I had where the root was still alive, but the grafted piece was gone. So I'm still waiting on this. I'm not going to mess with it right now. And then I did this one as well, which was another mystery branch. Initially, because I was trying to root it sort of in an air layer style, initially I had it in this pot, but then I figured, well, if it does root, you know, I don't want to go through the trauma of, or put it through the trauma of trying to separate the root. So I put it in its own pot. Pretty much did the same thing that I did before. I'm also trying to root this cutting. I've got knockout roses in the front of my yard, and I accidentally clipped it with a weed whacker. So I'm trying to get that to root. If it does, and I'll put that somewhere else. But so as far as this is concerned, I actually found, I had asked if anybody had a Red Delicious apple cutting. So I actually got one. So that's what this is. I came home one night from work and I had it sitting in paper in wet paper towel. I came home and just and grafted it on real fast. I think between this situation here and this, it took me maybe 5 minutes because I was working fast. So this is my Braeburn tree, but this is a Red Delicious branch. So hopefully that takes. This, I just did this last week. And then what I did was, because I clipped the Braeburn branch off to put the Red Delicious on. So the Braeburn that I took off, I put it on here and I grafted it onto my Mutsu. Now, what I did, I didn't take a branch off. I just kind of split and opened it up. And I had the cambium layers touching and then I just wrapped it. Now, it was cool doing it like that because when I opened it up from this side, because of the fact that it's, you know, it wasn't like a small branch, it really was easy to, I mean, it pretty much stayed on its own. I just tightened it and wrapped it. And so that's what we have here. So in a few weeks, you know, we'll see what happens. And let's see, let's take a look at a few other things real quick. Yeah, I'm about to cut my grass after I finish this. So, you know, I know y'all probably thinking this looks like a jungle. But even these weeds are gonna be used. So yeah, jungle time. Jungle boogie. All right, so here, this bed, I've got strawberries here, which have survived and they're doing pretty good. This one is fuzzy, but it's not really doing anything. But the way I look at it is like, as long as I have one, then when they set off runners, I'm good. If y'all can remember also, in these beds, I had moringa that I planted there. The moringa's gone. When we had that cold snap, it took out the moringa. So, you know, they're no longer with us, but I will be starting over. Here's my blueberries. Now, in the pots, I have, I put my coffee grounds in there. And I actually give it coffee sometime too, whatever coffee might be left over. Here's my blackberry. This is called the Sweetie Pie Blackberry. And she's looking all right. I discovered also that at the back of my property, I have like tons and tons of blackberries that are growing wild. So, you know, they're doing their thing too. So it was cool seeing that. It was a whole lot of them. These are my green onions. They're doing pretty good. The leeks didn't come through, but what I think I'm gonna do if they don't come through, I think I'm gonna plant some oregano and put those in there. Now this area, on camera, I don't really talk too much about it. Not because I don't want to. It's just that a lot of stuff in here, you know, I don't know how significant it is for you guys, but so a lot of it is like food that I regrew from the grocery store. So like right here, like all around this bed, all of that is garlic. Some of it is the garlic that, you know, we bought and looked like it was actually going bad and it came to life. And some of it was just garlic that I picked up and then bought. I've got leeks coming up here. This is comfrey. I've got comfrey growing. I'm just waiting for that to get taller. And then, you know, I'll chop that up. I got green onions here. Some of it is actually going to seed, which is fine. I mean, these green onions are huge. Now, family, like I said, this is stuff I did from... These green onions were green onions that I bought and used. I mean, I cut them all the way down and planted them. And these have been coming back year after year for like 3 years. I have some new ones that I just did, which are right here, probably about maybe 3 weeks ago. And I, like I said, I used them and then, you know, planted the stumps. And they rooted and then they made more onions. So, and we love green onions here. I've got... This is more comfrey. So this here, I don't know what this is for real. When I bought it, it said that it was a hydrangea, unless it's like a hydrangea species that I'm not familiar with, but it's never flowered. But I keep it here because it seems like the praying mantises love that bush. So, you know, I keep it there for the praying mantises. I like those. Here's some more garlic. We got rosemary growing, more rosemary growing. We got chives here. More garlic. Now these are broccolis. These were actually starts that I bought. And I got these starts like last fall and put them in. And it looks like they're trying to do something now. So I'll tend to them. Here's some more leeks that... I'm thinking I'll probably pull up and start over. I don't know. I'm just kind of, I don't know. Maybe they need more shade. I don't know what's going on with them. But those are leeks. This is where my secret potion is. We got more comfrey and more garlic. I mean, garlic all around. So I'm going to show you guys a few other things and then I'll let y'all go. So these three beds. Yay. All right, so the stuff that's growing in these beds now is navy beans. I let navy beans grow in there. Well, I actually threw the navy beans in the beds and I'm letting them grow in there just to give the beds more nitrogen. I also planted a few days ago onions and garlic around the edges of these two beds. So we'll see how that works out. Now this bed, this is the notorious doo-doo bed. And as you can see, of course, the beans have been growing a lot more in this bed because it had the manure in there. Now with this bed, I have the red solo cups going on here. I was telling you all, and I'm gonna do that in all the other ones, but I was telling you all that I'm gonna have to start my starts over again. So just to kind of know where they are, I put holes in the bottom for drainage, and I'll be planting my seeds in there. So what I'm thinking is gonna happen is once they get to the point where it's time to transfer, there's already a hole there and I can just transfer them right into the hole. But just to kind of keep an eye on them, you know, I'm gonna do them in cups, and like I said, I'll be doing that in the other beds as well. And so this bed is pretty good. Like, I was impressed because, you know, as I was putting the cups down, you know, I was pulling up the navy beans and just kind of dropping them. You know, the point of the beans, like I said, was to put more nitrogen into the soil, you know, not necessarily to get beans. Although I will be planting more of these beans because I love navy beans. I'm going to be planting more and putting them around the, or putting them in between the stuff that I grow here. But when I was pulling them, it was like this bed was teeming with worms. I mean, big, healthy looking, highly active worms. I mean, and they were like hopping out of the soil. You know, I had never seen them act like that before, and I'm assuming it was the manure. So I'm gonna try to replicate that next growing season. You know, I really don't wanna buy any more black cow or anything like that. I want to try to make things on my own. But I'm going to figure out a way that I can replicate that. This bed here, we got strawberries doing really good. This one's struggling, but she's still pulling. That one's struggling, and that one is struggling too. But this one is doing pretty good. Again, the moringa that was here in the middle is no longer with us. And let's see, let's go through the jungle. And I also have, this is lavender. So I'm hoping that I get like a nice big fat lavender bush right in the middle of this section here. And oh, and over here, this tub is where I planted some ginger. So we're waiting to see how that works out as well. And let me see, is there anything else? I think that would be it. Oh yeah, one other thing. So right here in this area, there's a sugarcane there. And that's the sugarcane that was in the house, and it was actually doing really good. And then I put it outside again, just like with the other stuff. I got that cold snap here, and the green part of it died, like the green shoot died. So I'm just gonna leave it there. I'm gonna keep it moist over here, keep it mulched, and see if it comes back. Hopefully it does. But if it doesn't, and actually, you know, even if it doesn't, I'm gonna have to hit up some people for some sugar cane. So if there's anybody that's selling it, let me know in the comments, and you know, we'll talk turkey. But anyway, family, that's it. I'm gonna get back to work, and I'll keep you all updated with everything else. Peace.